And you're watching NDTV Profit.
Mis-selling of financial products is rampant, not just in India, but across the globe. But you know what? You've got the power to stop it.
So we have some simple thumb rules for you to stop the financial advisor from mis-selling financial products.
All right, who's managing your money? Your banker, maybe your chartered accountant, or even a financial advisor, broking firm. How sure are you of being in the right hands? Do you simply trust him or her to do the best job for you? Right now, most financial intermediaries and advisors in India make money not on the right financial advice they provide you, but on the number of new products and high commission products they sell you. So do they really have your interest in mind? Or are they more busy pushing investments to earn commission? It's this dilemma which has perhaps prompted the regulator SEBI to propose a new variable commission on structure for mutual funds. What does that mean for you? And is it the way forward to stop mis-selling of investments? That's the big question of the day. Well, Monica, this is just actually the very beginning. Mutual funds are perhaps the cheapest of all financial products, and making that variable, how does that really stop the mis-selling of products? I mean, how does it really work?
I think we need to look at, first, we need to understand which cost this is. Mm-hmm. All financial products will bear three kinds of cost. There's a cost to get into the bus. It's called an entry load. There's a cost to ride the bus, which is a fund management fee. And there's a cost to get off the bus. So this is really the first of them. We're talking here of the entry load. Now, we need to understand that the SEBI rules allow mutual funds to charge 7% of entry plus exit, which means a total of 7% of your investment amount can be charged as a load. The industry norm today is 2.25%, which means on an investment of rupees 1 lakh, the agent will take away 2,250 rupees. Now, why the SEBI rule becomes interesting for us here is that till today you have no choice in this. You, when you make an investment, that amount will go to the agent because it's deducted from your investment amount. The SEBI rule is now saying that this commission, this fee to the agent, becomes a discussion between you, the investor, and the agent, which means that you're evaluating his service and the products that he's selling, the advice that he's giving, and then compensating the advisor. So you will actually have to sign on an agreement which says that I will compensate the advisor by so much. You will have two options in this to allow this structure today to continue, that it's deducted from your investment amount and the mutual fund will compensate the advisor. Or you will write him a separate check and that becomes his income for servicing you.